As my YouTube channel grows, I'm getting asked this question more and more frequently. Hey Dave, how do I effectively use your YouTube channel to learn data analysis with Excel? So this video is going to be a quick guide that will show you step by step which videos you should watch and in which order so that you can learn how to conduct data analyses in Excel the Dave on Data way. Now, I need to be very, very clear on this point. I have a very particular philosophy, a very particular view on data analysis. True data analysis is not about describing what happened in the business, but describing why things happened in the business. And those are two entirely different things. So for example, in the Excel world, things like pivot tables and charts and Excel dashboards are wildly useful for describing the what, but they typically have limited power in giving you insights into the why. So my focus on my channel is on the tools and techniques in Excel that you need to analyze data, to get insights into the why. And for that, you need a particular focus on data and on predictive analytics in particular. So this video will walk you through all of the content that I have on my channel that will teach you these skills so that you can get to the why of what's happening in the business. So here I have my YouTube channel up in incognito mode. And what I want to do is walk you through the videos and the order in which you should consume them if you're interested in maximizing the value of my channel in terms of you learning data analysis. So first up, there's the banner, and we'll ignore this guy. And we're going to ignore this playlist for a second. This is where you want to start. And arguably, the single most important video on my entire YouTube channel at the time of this recording, and probably likely for the foreseeable future, is this one right here. Business questions before data analytics. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, true data analysis is about understanding the why of what's going on in the business, not just the what. And to properly understand the why, you have to have the correct business questions first. That's before data analysis at all. And this video goes through the reasons why you need to focus on the business questions first and how the business questions then map into the types of data analytics techniques that are applicable for you to get to the why. So this video, super, super important. First video you should watch if you're not familiar at all with the content on my channel. Next up is this video right here, the predictive analytics guide. Generally speaking, you're going to use predictive analytics techniques to answer the why. There's descriptive analytics, things like pivot tables and charts and Excel dashboards, and those are all wildly useful. Don't get me wrong, they're extremely useful. However, if you really want to get to the why of what's going on in the business in a particular situation, you need predictive analytics techniques. And this video right here should be number two on your list, and it will explain to you a number of options that you have using trusty old Excel to do predictive analytics to get to the why. Now, these two videos here are optional. Oftentimes, folks have a conceptual problem mapping a particular general technique, for example, linear regression, to a particular business domain in which they work. So these videos are optional, and what they do is they show how various analytical techniques map to the HR domain and the marketing domain to give you some sort of flavor, some sort of indication, some sort of idea of how these general techniques that I teach on my channel can be applied to basically any business area. So this is where you start. Video number one, video number two. So once you've got that in place, the next thing that you need to know how to do is to clean and wrangle your data. And I would skip over this playlist and go directly to Power Query. And here's the reason for this. Power Query is awesome. It's simply awesome. Not only can you use Power Query to acquire and clean and wrangle your data for advanced and predictive analytics, you can also use Power Query itself to implement some of the analytics techniques that I'll be talking about later in this video. So Power Query, if you're serious about doing real data analysis, true data analysis with Excel, Power Query is a must-have skill. So this is your next stop, right? Watch those two videos that I talked about above and then start consuming the Power Query. And then next up on the list is exploratory data analysis. This is step three, if you want to think of it this way. And here's the reason for why this is step number three. Because maybe you're thinking, geez, Dave, I want to do the cool stuff. Why do I got to learn all this other stuff first? Let me explain why. Crafting, creating, building useful predictive analytics is both difficult and time consuming. And anything that you can do to make sure that you're stacking the odds in your favor for predictive analytics is a good thing. And exploratory data analysis is the second most important thing. The first is obviously getting your data, cleaning the data, and wrangling the data. That's number one, right? Without data, no analytics. Second up is exploratory data analysis. EDA helps you not only increase the probability that what you're going to do is going to be useful in the predictive analytics space, it also reduces your cycle time because you will get lots of powerful insights into the why by doing exploratory data analysis. So generally speaking, in the data science realm, the data analytics realm, most practitioners that are hands-on spend most of their time acquiring, cleaning, wrangling data, and exploring data. We spend far more time in these activities than we actually do in the predictive analytics space. Estimates are anywhere between 60 to 80% of your project time is getting your data, understanding your data, cleaning your data, wrangling your data, exploring your data, repeating that cycle. And then once you're good to go, then you start doing the predictive analytics. Moving on. So let's talk about predictive analytics, okay? Now that you understand your business questions and you've wrangled and acquired and cleaned your data and then you've explored your data, now you're good to go to do predictive analytics, to do the types of advanced analytics that allows you to get to the why. And that's where data mining techniques come into play. Data mining encompasses a number of advanced analytics techniques, including predictive analytics like market basket analysis and naive Bayes, but also other techniques like k-means clustering. Cluster analysis is super, super useful. Strictly speaking, it's not a predictive analytics technique, but it is a wildly useful thing. And as I mentioned earlier, to implement k-means clustering in Excel, you need to use Power Query. So this is an example of where Power Query not only helps you with your data, but also helps you implement advanced analytics with your data. So this is the next step, right? Watch this summary video here, this top four countdown. It'll give you some context around data mining that will also augment the predictive analytics video that you've watched earlier. So this is step four. Eventually, you might reach a point where you need more power. You need more power than what Excel can provide out of the box. And that's where SQL programming comes in. Now, I'm not saying that everybody that comes to my channel to learn data analysis needs to learn SQL programming, but a good chunk of you will. Because SQL programming is super, super powerful. It allows you to acquire, clean, and wrangle data at scales far beyond what you can do in Excel, both practically using out-of-the-box Excel and even using something like Power Pivot. I mean, like, if you're talking about a billion rows of data, you're not using Power Pivot for that. But you can do that sort of thing in a database using SQL. So this is a must-have for people who need more power in their analytics. And you might be pleasantly surprised at how easy learning SQL is for an Excel user. And my whole tutorial series takes your Excel knowledge as the frame of reference and then uses that knowledge to teach you SQL in a fun and easy way. And not surprisingly, I'm also focusing on the subset of SQL that's maximally useful for business professionals. So that's where you go next. Lastly, if you need even more power in your analytics, that's where we can go back up to here. And this section of my channel right here, you'll notice that they have the full webinar in parentheses. That's to let you know what kind of video these are. These are videos that talk about the online courses that I sell via Dave on Data. So some things I definitely give away free of charge based on the YouTube channel, but as a businessman, I need to make some revenue, and I also sell online courses. And these videos show you how you can use your Excel skills to up-level and unlock advanced analytics. So for example, here's how you can do KPI analysis in a robust way using just Excel. This is how you can use your Excel skills to learn R programming. Or if you're even more interested in a larger transformation, this video will show you how my online courses will take you all the way from analyzing data in Excel pivot tables to R programming, and then all the way to machine learning, if that's what you're interested in doing. So that is the base path through my channel for learning data analysis with Excel. Now, I'm going to give you a couple bonus items just in case there are certain people that are interested in this. And at the very bottom here, you can see that I have a playlist for folks that are interested in landing a formal analytics role. And you can check out some of these videos here around that. And if you're ever interested in learning more about R programming, you can check these videos out down here. And that is my YouTube channel in a nutshell. All right, to make things super easy for you, I'm going to put the first two videos on my channel that you should watch here and here. Be sure to check them out. If you found this content useful, if you think it might be helpful for other professionals interested in learning data analysis, if you'd give me a like on this video, that would be greatly, greatly appreciated. That's it. That's how you learn data analysis with Excel using my YouTube channel. Until next time, please stay healthy, and I wish you very happy data sleuthing.